the types of experiments we did for this is we would have a mouse in a chamber, and the mouse has to place their snout into a port. So that's the work that they're doing, and the payout for that work is to get sucrose. And we did one technique in which we actually record the activity of these cells, and that revealed that these cells become very active when mice are working very, very hard but not getting what they're expecting, and then ultimately give up. There are multiple different areas in the brain that kind of coordinate when that tipping point is reached, but I think that we've demonstrated here that this group of cells, these nociceptin cells, are definitely a voice that are telling the dopamine cells and ultimately the animal to give up. In terms of actually developing medications and trying to treat psychiatric disease, these nociceptin cells directly influence dopamine levels in the brain. So it's known that many diseases have to do with dysregulation of dopamine, such as depression is characterized as a reduction in dopamine. This system that we're reporting could potentially be turned off and on with different medications or drugs to influence how much dopamine is released and kind of reduce the symptoms of a lot of these psychiatric disorders. It's difficult to say what the end clinical outcome will be, since this is really a basic science discovery and really the first step towards developing treatments based around manipulating this nociceptin system. But it's certainly well positioned to have an influence on these diseases because it has such profound influence on dopamine release. But this is one of the first works to really show that these complex molecules known as neuropeptides can actually influence behavior through the VTA. And that itself is very scientifically important and also potentially targetable with different medications.